when you have a sphere, you have a top of a sphere here, you know that you can cut that up from the top of the North Poles are covering the auditorium. Behind, you can see all this whole group. It's only the half of it. It has the symmetrical part to go with it.
Jørn Utzon's design was, what you can say, on the edge of the possible. He was so determined when he created his architecture to do absolutely the best, combining vision and fantasy with the rational and the buildable, and that's why we have architectural icons from Utzon today. When designing the Opera House, the construction of the shells were immensely complex, and the engineers and the architect hadn't solved it, and Utzon found new ways of doing it. With a fantastic ability to understand space and geometry, he solved complex things through simple models. He used whatever was around. He used Lego blocks, he used sugar cubes on a coffee table, or he used salt on a dinner table to do drawings or small models to engage with his family or with colleagues to describe what he wanted from architecture. When working on the Sydney Opera House, Utzon met Paul Ahm. He was a structural engineer and he collaborated with Utzon on the first conceptual work, and Utzon designed his house. So you see that the Ahm House is the first house where he works with concrete and the first modern house in the 20th century. It has the light and the openness of a modern house plan. And you have the brickwork and the wooden ceilings and on the floor, the tiles from the Opera House. He said that his laboratory was the forest and the beaches and the clouds. When he looked at nature, he saw complexity and beauty, but he also saw rationality. And that's what he translated into his own architecture. He traveled around the world to find what he called the seeds of architecture. And to a large extent, canvas, which he built for his wife, and his family shows all the things that Utzon worked with in his career. You'll experience North African architecture, you'll see Japanese architecture, you'll see Danish architecture. When entering, you also feel that you are in an ancient ruin, but it is a modern simplicity at the same time. When he formed architecture out of concrete, it was about giving new possibilities in terms of constructions. But when he worked with bricks, it's about using local materials. And canvas is made of the most simple materials that you made agricultural buildings from in Mallorca, which again feels so right in the place it's situated. He understood what is important in architecture. And I think it's his sensibility and the kind of essence of finding key experiences in architecture. He focused on the experience of one human being in one place. And that is what makes Utzon so different from his peers. He said that happiness has to be counted in seconds. And the example is the famous ray of light in canvas slowly crossing up the wall, describing our relationship to time, to nature, to seasons, and what it is to be a human being in the world.